Okay, hi guys. So in this lecture, we'll be starting off with Perkin's condensation. Okay, so let's get started. So we have Perkin's condensation. Okay, so we can just write it like this, that it's a short trick to remember that Perkin's aromatic aldehyde gets converted into unsaturated acid. Okay, so suppose we have aromatic aldehyde which on passing with anhydride we get, obviously in presence of CH3 CO2 minus Na plus. Okay, and we take 5 hours for this reaction to complete, just writing 5 hours here, and then secondly we pass S3O plus and heat it. So what is the product which will be getting? So first, in the first step, what will happen is we are passing it in 5 hours and we are giving it ample time. So generally what will happen is CH2 minus will not react with the CH3 to get it converted into CH2 minus. Obviously why? Because CH2 minus will take the reaction into the backward direction. Okay, but when we are giving ample time for this to take place, what will happen is double bond will take place and the dehydration will take place from this two compounds, and as a result we'll be getting something like this. And again on passing it secondly aceting medium, so what will we be getting? The cleavage across this bond will take place, and as a result we'll be getting something like this, CH CO2 H. okay, so this is known as alpha beta unsaturated acid or cinnamic acid. Okay, this is alpha beta unsaturated acid. Okay, or this is also known as cinnamic acid, is the common name for this compound. Okay, so before going forward, I'll just like to bring a fact here that LDA is lithium diisopropyl amine. Lithium diisopropyl, and it is a very strongly hindered base, strongly sterically hindered base. Okay, and the formula is Li plus, and we have N minus this. Okay, so just as a fact you can remember it, but you should not expect questions on it. The questions, even if asked, is very very rarely asked in J level competitive examinations. So for the scope of this video lectures, we are not going deep into this. Okay, so next let's discuss Reformitsky reaction. Okay, Reformitsky reaction. Okay, so Reformitsky reaction is, suppose we have RBr. okay, and in RBr if we are passing Mg, then it becomes RmgBr. okay, if we pass Li, then it becomes RLi, and if we pass zinc, then it becomes RZnBr. okay, secondly if we pass something like OCHCH2, then so if we have this compound, okay, and when we react this compound obviously with This is an example, not a second point. So when we react this compound with RmgBr, obviously this would be a first addition reaction, okay, wherein R minus will attack on this partial positively charged carbon atom, and I hope you can make the products of the same when we again we are passing H3O medium. So I hope you can make the products of it, okay. So next let's discuss or let's revise some of the previously seen examples wherein we use benzaldehyde, and if we pass it on with RAlD4 and D2O, what would be the product form? Product form would be something like pH COD DN H. This would be the product form, okay. And if we pass PCC into it, what will happen is the mild oxidation or reductive oxidation will take place, in which we'll be getting something like this and D present here, okay. So this would be the final product which we'll be getting, okay. And if we pass this compound onto this product as a reagent, so we'll be getting something like this product, okay. Again, if we pass, let's say, R Li on the top of it, so we'll be getting that R minus will be taking this H plus, so as a result we'll be getting something like P C minus and S. And again, if we pass this it in D2O water, so what will we be getting? We'll be getting that these two are broken up by the, or rather it's not still broken up. We are, when we are passing D2O, what will happen is first C minus will actually attack on D to form something like this compound, and then if we hydrolyze it and if we provide a little bit of heating, then the breaking of this bond will take place, and as a result we'll be getting something like this compound as the final product, okay. And what if we pass onto this compound H2 nickel? This would be a Mozingo reaction, okay. And as a result we will be getting again this H and H, S and S will be breaking up, and as a result we'll be getting pH C H and 2H in place of 2S, which will be cleaved by H2 nickel, okay. So this is a Mozingo reaction, okay. So with this we come to an end of this lecture. In the next lecture we'll be seeing concepts on internal forces in biomolecular or internal forces in biomolecules, okay. So till then, good luck and goodbye.